I must have cut it on the ashtray. I want to check out the truck a bit.
Okay.
You just stay here, okay?
Are you okay?
I guess so. You were way over the center line, kid.
Yeah, I know. Look, I'm sorry.
Hey, are you hurt?
Oh, no, no, it's just a little cut. Hey, do you want my license or anything?
No, forget it. I got a schedule to keep.
Look, I'm awfully sorry. It's my honeymoon. Right there.
What?
Just stand right there, okay? Just 1 minute. 1 minute.
Oh, no, 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 no!
Why?
Not against this wallpaper. It looks terrible. Please, no. No.
What?
No, no, no. Put it away.
fanciest casino in town, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Come here. Do you have the key?
Yeah, it's right here.
Good. Okay, let's go.
Opinion, Daniel, as director of casino security, this equipment constitutes the most effective deterrent against cheating and robbery.
You think this is a pretty hot setup, don't you, Oscar?
Don't you?
Ah, but Oscar, there is one thing that this baby won't do. Suppose a known cheater walks through the door.
Well, we can simply lock in on him from the moment he steps through that door.
Ah, but the camera can't recognize him. But if he had a pit boss or a guard or a cocktail waitress, well, I suppose she could call this office.
No need. He or she simply presses a concealed button down there. Automatically, the cameras switch around to that location and start video recording. And so you see, we may not be using your services as frequently as we have in the past.
Ah, but Oscar, who would you play gin rummy with? Just one suggestion. Don't keep it a secret. The more people who know Big Brother is watching, the fewer problems you're gonna have, right?
Number three.
First, we're gonna go to the bar.
Oh.
We're gonna go to the bar.
Okay. Yes. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bartender.
Yes, sir.
Champagne. Bottle.
Pink champagne, please. Jack, I just can't believe it. We're rich.
Well, no, I wouldn't exactly call $600 rich.
Oh.
Well, it isn't a bad start either.
Told you I felt lucky tonight.
I don't know how lucky you make me feel. Baby, you don't know how much you've given me. But you know something? I never got you a wedding gift.
Oh.
Now, I'm going to take care of that right now.
You don't have to do that.
No, but I want you. And you wait right here. And I'll be right back. I'm going over to the jewelry store, okay?
Paging Mr. Butler, Mr. Jack
Butler. Oh, it's almost 5 minutes to eight.
Thanks.
Would you like a little more champagne?
Oh, no thanks. You know, I can't think what's happened to my husband. He must be buying out the whole store. I better go find him.
Okay, I'll take care of this for you until you get back.
Oh, thanks very much. We won't be long.
Help you?
Oh, yes. I'm looking for my husband. He came in here to buy me a present.
Ah, what does he look like?
Oh, well, he's about 6 feet tall. He's got brown hair and green eyes, and he's well-built. He's got a beautiful smile.
Honey, if anybody like that walked in here, I'd remember him. As a matter of fact, the only customers I've waited on the last hour were old ladies.
Are you sure?
Yeah, and I'm the only one here. Maybe he went back up to the room.
Oh, no, we're not staying at this hotel.
Tell you what, why don't you go over there and pick up a house phone and have him paged?
Oh, of course. Thank you very much.
Sure.
Paging Mr. Gary Cole. Mr. Gary Cole.
I see. Yes. Thanks.
Hey.
What have you done with our things? Now listen, this room belongs to my husband and me.
Why don't you open that door? Listen, I don't know what's going on here, but why don't you turn right around and get on out of here, hmm?
But I'm sure that...
What'd you do, find this in the street? Or did you steal it from the front desk, huh?
No, now
are you going to get on out of here? Or do we have to call a manager and have you forcibly removed?
No, I can't be wrong. Listen, it can't be happening again. God, I'm over that. I don't care what the desk clerk says. That's my room. Mine and Gary's.
Where's Gary?
I told you, Lieutenant. We were over at the Desert Inn and he just disappeared. Find him for me and find out what's going on, please. That's our room.
Not according to the desk clerk or the registration slips. The clerk says she never checked into the Mint.
What am I supposed to do? No one will listen to me. I just kept yelling at the desk clerk and the manager till they called the police. If you won't help me, who will?
Hi.
You took your sweet time getting here?
Got here as soon as I could. I had a hot date. You owe me one, Dave.
Mrs. Cole, this is Dan Tanner. He's a private detective.
Mrs. Cole?
The lady needs some help, Dan.
The kind of help we can't give her.
What seems to be the problem?
Well, let's just call it the case of the missing hotel room.
And when the desk clerk said that he couldn't even find a record that Gary and I had ever checked in, that's when... Well, that's when I lost control.
Oh, Wendy, are you sure that it was the right hotel? I mean, it was late at night. You have a few drinks sometimes.
Mr. Tanner, I only had one glass of champagne. Look. I don't have much money, but I do need your help.
That's okay. From what you told us, you and your husband talked to several people at the Desert Inn. It shouldn't be too hard to check your story. No problem. I'll check and see who was on duty early this evening. Okay, where else did you go?
The bar. The bartender will remember me.
Good. Come on.
Paging Mr. Cohen. Mr. Bert Cohen.
Paging
Mrs. Cohen.
Alex.
Oh, hi, Mr. Tanner. Ma'am.
How you doing?
Oh, fine.
Listen, you remember this lady, don't you?
No. Why, should I?
Should you? I was here earlier, right here with my husband. He went to get me a present at the jewelry store.
I'm sorry, ma'am. There must be some kind of mistake. I've never seen you before.
What do you mean you've never seen me before? You remember me? We ordered champagne, pink champagne, and I didn't want any more champagne. And why are you lying? Why aren't you telling the truth? You know who I am. You remember me? Why are you doing this?
Montana investigations.
Binzer, wake up. I want you to call Granite Falls, Wyoming for me. Check out on Miss Wendy Nash and a Mr. Gary Cole.
Nash, as in teeth, and Cole, as in old king.
Good, let me know when you found something.
So you don't believe me either.
Wendy, I didn't say that. But everything you've told me so far, it just doesn't check out.
I told you, they're all lying.
Wendy, why would they be lying?
I don't know.
The only ID you have is your own name, Nash.
Gary has the wedding certificate.
And the car's not in the parking lot where you say your husband left it. We can't even find him.
Oh, Mr. Tanner, that's what scares me more than anything. You gotta believe me.
I'm trying, Wendy.
Please. I'm telling the truth.
Think.
All right. I might be confused about some things, but if I can just find my husband, you gotta help me. You gotta find Gary for me. Please.
If I find him, will he know you?
What I call a lousy break. Minor highway mishap.
Kid gets a scratch in his hand. Discharge line on tanker. Springs a small leak.
If we hadn't picked him up so fast, it could have been 1,000 times worse.
A panic. A national disaster. And now you understand why it's imperative that you escort every tanker on a special run.
Yes, sir, I sure do. What beats me is how you got Washington to move so quickly.
Washington? They'd still be deliberating. Calling people off the golf course, trying to set up some sort of a meeting.
You took this action on your own?
I assume full responsibility, Ross. We simply couldn't wait. Now, don't worry. It's just a question of time before they approve my decision. Now then, first thing in the morning, I want you to drive me into town. Oscar Duncan, security director at the Desert Inn. Paul, he seems to have a problem.
I thought everybody was cooperating. Yay, the bartender.
Yeah, well, there's an unexpected development. The girl's gotten herself a private detective, a fellow named Dan Tanner. Hey, you check him out.
Yes. How's the boy doing?
Well, we're doing everything we can. I'd be surprised if he lasts through the night.
Good, you brought the clothes for Wendy.
Yeah.
Breakfast is almost ready.
Oh, terrific. I'm starved. Thank you.
Here you are.
Dan, do you really believe her story?
Yeah, I do, B. Maybe it's the way she talks about her husband. I don't know. But I do believe her.
The cow's here.
Shh. You save some eggs for you, staying warm on the stove.
Out of sight.
What'd you find out in your call to Granite Falls?
Well, Wendy Nash lives there, okay, but I couldn't get in touch with her parents.
Well, who'd you call?
I talked to the police. And they told me that his father owns a small farm just outside of town. I'm going to have a piece of bacon. Thank
sure,
you very much.
So.
They'll try and get him to call us as soon as they can. Collect, of course.
Of course.
Listen, it's a small town, you know, and the cop, like, knows everybody. He said she was really strange, that she spent a lot of time by herself, and also that she spent a couple of months in some kind of hospital.
Hospital? What kind of hospital?
Well, he wouldn't say what kind of hospital, but I'll tell you what I think.
In polite societies, it's referred to as a mental institution. Gary was on the construction crew, working on the new dam outside of town.
Yeah?
Even my shrink said he was the best thing that ever happened to me.
So are you alone?
Yeah, it was Gary's idea. I loved him for it. A honeymoon in Las Vegas, Nevada.
Don't worry, Wendy. You're going to have that honeymoon. You and I are going to find Gary and that missing hotel room.
Yes? What do you want now?
My name is Dan Tanner. We think there's been a mix-up at the room.
Oh, yeah? She still claims this is her room, huh?
No, I know this sounds wild, and I know this room is registered to Mr. Stein and family, but just checking out her story. You mind if I come in?
Yes, I do mind. I've had enough of this. This woman upset my wife and kid last night, busting in here, half-bomb, getting hysterical. We're here on a vacation. We don't need this kind of aggravation, right, huh? So now, if you don't mind, we've got things to do.
Oh, Mr. Tanner, am I crazy? Am I?
I told you he was going to be a problem.
I thought you had all the bases covered, Ross.
That's right, Stein. Everywhere the couple went and everyone they spoke to from the moment they hit town.
Everybody's been cooperating. You've done a fine job, Ross.
Then how come Tanner's threatening to blow the whole operation? What makes him so different?
I checked him out and he's not for sale. Well, there's no really safe way to approach him.
There is one way that's safe and sure.
Would you excuse us, please? At stake here. The immense responsibility that's been given us.
What are you suggesting?
History shows it's always the bravest and the best who are called upon to make the greatest sacrifices for the general good. Tanner must be eliminated.
No. I've never questioned orders before. But I won't have any part of this.
Don't worry.
I'll take care of Tanner.
I'll see that you don't regret it.
Hi, is the justice in?
Oh, dear, I'm afraid not. The trout are running, you see? He left before sunup. I'm his housekeeper. Could I be of assistance?
Well, yes, my name is Dan Tanner, a private investigator. I was wondering if we could take a look at his record book.
Oh, I don't think I could let you do that.
Well, ma'am, I assure you, you would not be breaking the law in any way, and it's really very important.
Well, in that case, I guess I can let you do it. Come in.
Now, if you'll tell me what you're looking for, perhaps I can save you some time.
Well, I'm looking for the record of a wedding.
Whose?
Mine. I stood right here. My husband stood right there. Don't you remember me?
I'm sorry, you must forgive me. I've only been here a few months.
Months? This was yesterday. It was 4 o'clock in the afternoon. You witnessed the ceremony.
We did no weddings yesterday.
You stood right there. You gave me flowers to pin onto my dress. You hugged me afterwards. You kissed my cheek.
I don't know what's going on here, but I think you two had better leave.
Tommy, she wished me happiness. She kissed my cheek. She did.
You did the right thing in bringing her here, Mr. Tanner. Are you a relative?
I know, Doctor, I'm not, but it seems I'm all she's got right now.
Well, from what you told me about her recent experiences, I'm not surprised that she suffered a relapse.
I can get the name of her doctor. You can have her case history sent down from Granite Falls. Is there anything else I can do?
Yes. Find her husband and prove that everything that happened happened just the way she said it did. That's the only way I'm gonna save her sanity.
It's preposterous, Daniel. The girl is obviously quite mad.
Now, that girl would agree with you right now, Oscar, but I don't. And I'm asking for your help. Now, talk to the dealer, talk to the bartender, get him to tell me the truth.
Sorry, at the moment my hands are full.
I think somebody got to him. Maybe they got to you, too.
Wait a minute. Last night, when you and I were running the monitor test, it was just after 7:30. Now, that's the time Wendy says that she and her husband were in the casino.
Now, Oscar, I want that tape.
I wiped it.
Like hell you did.
Now listen to me, Daniel. I'm your friend. You don't know what you're into. Drop it now.
And leave some girl in a psychiatric hospital believing she's crazy? Now, I don't care who or what's behind all this. I'm not standing still for it, Oscar. Now, you hear me.
Which one of these is the right tape, or do I have to run all of them?
Did the right thing, Oscar.
Now watch closely. That is Gary Cole. He's not a figment of somebody's demented imagination, Dave.
Doesn't prove that a crime was committed or that it's any of my business.
Dave, what are you talking about? A young man is missing.
Well, maybe he's missing because he wants to take off with the winnings.
Okay. Have you got anything on Cole's car?
Nothing yet, because I haven't had the time.
Got your hands full? Like Oscar Duncan? You're shutting me out, Dave. Why? Have you been given orders? From whom?
Now, you understand something, Dan. I don't like this any better than you do. If it was left up to me, I wouldn't let any federal agency do it. But it's not left up to me. You see, I'm just a working cop. And the commissioners don't agree with me. They're political people. But they're my bosses. This thing's a lot more important than you think it is, Dan.
More important than a girl's life. Okay, Dave. If you say so.
Dan.
Dave, you're the one who asked me to help this girl. Now, I need your help. I don't know where to go.
Where to go? Man, do you drink milk? You know, my grandfather believed that milk had a whole lot of healing properties. In fact, when all of his friends were drinking whiskey, he drank a glass of milk every day. You should try it. He lived to be 98.
Well, Dave, I drink milk once in a while. Why?
Good for you. What brand?
I don't know. The local brand. It's in all the local stores. I don't know the name of it.
Yeah, I think I know. Good milk. Big company. In fact, they even have a dairy farm about 40 miles south of town. I got work to do. I'll see you later.
Binzer. Yes, I know what time it is. Get right over here. I'll explain when you get here.
Dan? Dan?
Binzer.
Down there.
Now listen, this thing under my foot is a mine. Anti-personnel.
Oh. Aren't they all? Is this gonna blow up?
Not unless I take my foot off of it.
Don't move.
Now this is a pressure release type. I need something heavy to put on the trigger.
Books. You want me to get some books?
It's not heavy enough. I've got some weights, some extra weights for my barbells in the closet. Get me 250s.
Don't move. You all right?
Yeah.
Where do you want him?
Put him right there.
Move this baby can go.
Oh.
deadline. Mm.
Get the door. Get the door.
Okay.
Careful!
You're going after him, aren't you?
Yep.
Want me to come with you?
No, thanks.
Yeah, here.
It's all starting to make sense. That mine was Army hardware.
So what are you going to do, go after the United States Army?
Hey, they started it.
Put it down. Now turn around. Turn around slowly.
I'm Colonel Mitchell, commander of this installation. You're trespassing on restricted military property. We can shoot you as an intruder.
You just might have to do that, Colonel. Because that's the only way you'll stop me from telling the public that this dairy farm, 35 miles from Las Vegas, is really a cover for some secret storage facility.
When this facility was constructed during World War II, Las Vegas was a very small town. No one expected it to grow this quickly. Unstable biological and chemical warfare materials are transported here, broken down, rendered harmless. And we are very proud of our safety record.
We've never had an accident.
Until now.
We have contained the danger. And now, Mr. Tanner, you can understand in the national interest, this base must remain secret.
Go ahead and shoot me. If you really believe that's your duty. Like kidnapping some kid on his honeymoon, driving his wife half crazy.
That was unintentional.
It was a one in a million freak accident. The boy had an open cut in his hand. He touched a leaking valve on one of our tankers and was immediately infected.
We could not allow this boy to infect others, create an epidemic.
Why didn't you call in medical experts?
He was dead the minute he touched that truck.
The boy is alive. He's young and strong, but we have to get him to a hospital.
Out of the question.
I can't believe the U.S. Army would condone this.
Sergeant, have you seen orders from Washington?
That's none of his business.
Written orders.
No.
It must be obvious to you that the Colonel has overstepped his bounds of authority.
I believe that Colonel Mitchell is suffering from stress and from exhaustion and has acted irrationally, in which case...
Boss, you know what you're saying.
In which case he is unfit for duty and must be relieved of his command.
Ross!
Then you better relieve him, Sergeant Ross. Because if you don't, you better be prepared for that young boy to be shot, and yourself, because he can't let any of us get out of here alive.
Sergeant, escort the Colonel to his quarters.
No way. I don't take orders from you.
No!
All right. I had to act immediately, obtain civilian cooperation any way I could. The General will understand me, and I'm going to see him now, personally.
That boy to a hospital.
Drop it. Move.
Such a beautiful watch.
Well, now you two have all the time in the world.
We plan to make the most of it, too. But, you know, I still don't understand what this is all about. I mean, all I remember is some guy coming up behind me back there at the showcase.
Well, Sergeant Ross made a statement. One of his men stuck a gun in your back and walked you out to your car.
And then I must have passed out. Yeah. And I woke up in a cot in the room where you found me. But what was the place?
Well, it was a place that shouldn't have been so close to Las Vegas. And thanks to you and Wendy, it's been closed down now. And you've done the city an invaluable service, and I've talked to the mayor, and the rest of your honeymoon's on him.
Oh, that's wonderful. There's only one problem.
What's that?
Now that Gary's bought me the watch, I don't know how we're gonna pay you.
Well, no problem. I'll send my bill to the Pentagon. They can take it out of my taxes. But right now, I think we should take this $20 bill, hit the roulette table, run it up to 200, and buy ourselves a gourmet dinner. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, if you're gonna bet, you might as well go for broke. $20 on double zero. Come on.
Yeah. You never win at this. You know the odds of getting that? 35-1.
It's not gonna happen.
I love Las Vegas.